Ladies and gentlemen, welcome again. Today we have a nice game of Dakairos versus Aslan. There's actually a high difference between both of the players. Like Dakairos, one of the best players of the world, and Aslan is like a very good player, like the, let's say, the 20% of the best players worldwide. And like active players, if you lose a lot of games, you will surely stop gaming, and you will know that your mathematical logics are not the perfect ones, and so we will stop to play this game. But at the moment, we can see that Aslan is going for a good wood production right here, as well as his food production right here. And yeah, after a few games you always know which ones you will look at in a second. So and you find every mistake in a second. And so he's going for yeah, Dakairos is going for more wood, but at the moment here we have some idols, which is quickly solved. Idols is the biggest problem, of course, because idle means no economy, and if you don't have economy you can't boom. And if you can't get a big boom, you can't get resources, and you wouldn't expand your territory. And everything is combined with each other. I mean, at the first view, it looks very simple, strategic, but if you have all the mathematics inside, you surely alone this farm means so much, because it reduces time and all the gathering time. And yeah, I think this is a replay that's very interesting in the end, so we will go fast forward to just check this out, indeed. What's going on. We have a little rush with two cavalries retreating and, from this low hit point side. But actually Aslan is a very underrated player. Like, he plays a lot better than 1400. He plays like, I would say, almost 1-7 or something like that. He played against BML and won this game twice, which is crazy. He also won against me one game. And so you can say that he's not a bad player at all. And Dakairos is going for his wood right here. Or his barracks. I don't know if it's any difference if you go 5 or if you go 3. If you go 1, you have 10 and 25. And yeah, this should be equal. And yeah, everything. Like, after a few weeks, you will understand the mathematics that's behind, and there's nothing more to do than to react. But actually, at the moment it's extremely easy, but the game gets complexer if you go to later phases. Like, Dakairos tries to get his Noba Dorf up, which means that he can play a little bit more from the middle of the map, which is actually very nice. And yeah, he gets scouted, and so we got some action. Yeah, that's interesting. Like, there's no absolute strategy. Both players decide to retreat. And here also a lot of losses for Aslan, but he builds a temple, but he can't bring them back. He can't bring them back. Yeah, from the upgrades, only this upgrade. And yeah, the economy, both players play like equal, like population. Oh no, Dakairos has a good lead. He has an intense lead of 20 people. So what's happening right here? It's the spearmen are right here in front of it, and yeah, I think it's good. Spearmen should be going against cavalry, but no player can do that in the very, very fast time that he can manage everything perfectly. So that's absolutely normal if you... also some micromanagement fail. I would call it a bug. Like, if you have a ram right here, the ram could not move. There's also a lot of situations where units are completely stuck and they can't move at all. And so you first have to find it out, and then you can you understand how to use it. But the problem with it is that it sometimes seems not very logical in the first moment. And yes, that's what's going on. And this is very, very nice indeed. Yeah, but I think these are for neither player really very good, because both retreat and you should only fight when you're in better numbers. I would call maybe a few from the back. Yeah, but they are too far away. That makes sense. And the Kairos has a big lead in the moment, while from the ratio, both players are on the same level. They have a high amount, but also a high amount of losses, of course. And the Kairos is circling from the other side. Where will he go? No, that's not so good. Alright, so the Kairos tries to come from the other side, and maybe he will get some. Let's have a close look. Aslan is attacking, though he has a lower population. Maybe I would have waited a little bit longer for Aslan instead of attacking right now. I mean, it's an excellent logic, like what is behind the play style of both, but as you can see, here are also small mistakes. Okay, one Berg falls of the Kairos, but he gets the lead, I think. Yeah, obviously, he really gets the lead, but he has nothing to do to this Rams. Nothing, just nothing. It's really crazy, yeah. So he goes to push even further. And let's have a look at the upgrades. And this is the GG. Like, the Kairos won the game. And yeah, that's very, very nice. And you can check the upgrades right here, which is very nice. And so if you got a good replay, let me know.